I think it's very, very important that in Illinois we have a tollway system that's efficient and modern, safe, and most of all, honest. And upon getting sworn into office in January of last year, I felt it was very important, and any person that I named to the tollway board be someone of the highest integrity, and they are, and also carry out the mission of making sure that the tollway is all about transportation and getting people to where they have to go in an efficient, prudent manner, as economically as possible. Today we're going to be signing a bill that helps continue that good job. There's going to be an inspector general established by law at the tollway to have a formal inspector general, independent, someone who can carry out the kind of eyes and ears that the public needs to protect the common good and protect the toll payers. For all those who throw money in the basket or use an I-pass, I think it's important that we always ensure that the tollway is run on the square.
Crime and corruption are words we commonly hear in Illinois associated with state government. In our continuing efforts to rid Illinois, and specifically some state agencies, of this culture, the governor is taking a critical step today by signing legislation that creates an independent inspector general at the Illinois Toll Highway Authority. The tollway is being transformed from a politically connected patronage haven for insiders to a well-run, well-respected agency that provides efficiencies and ethical standards that will benefit all taxpayers. This transformation has been under the leadership of Chairman Paula Wolf, who is here with us today, and who has initiated much-needed transparency and oversight measures to an agency that once subscribed to backroom, not boardroom standards. Establishing an independent IG office at the tollway is further proof that Illinois can shed its culture of corruption reputation and take the high road, ensuring that our taxpayers are well protected and that their needs are well addressed at the highest level.
When the governor and I first talked about this appointment, he made it very clear that one of the highest priorities was going to be to restore the integrity of the tollway and to do that through transparency. Immediately after my being appointed, Senator Garrett started holding a series of hearings, which were extremely illuminating for those of us who thought we knew what we were getting into, and uncovered a lot of things that led to further analysis out at the tollway. An immediate issue was the question of whether we could actually create an independent entity at the tollway. Working with Senator Garrett and working with the governor and people in the governor's office, this legislation was drafted with also the help of the Attorney General. And we're very, very grateful to Senator Garrett and to Representative Nekritz, both for the work that they did in pointing us in the right direction and also drafting and helping to pass the legislation.
As Executive Director, I certainly welcome the authority of this new Inspector General to the tollway. I think it's going to be a tremendous partnership and bring tremendous opportunities to add integrity to the process and make sure that everything we do and every decision we make is above board and above reproach. We need to restore the public trust in this agency, and as the governor has stated and as his signing of this legislation will do today, we will take great strides, I think, in that direction. The new tollway inspector general will also have the independence to ensure integrity and transparency, and that is the operating standard for our agency. This office will be obligated to publicly report and present summaries of their work to the governor, the legislature, and the board of directors on a regular basis. So nothing will happen behind closed doors with our new inspector general's office in place. So we've taken these directives for more transparency and accountability to heart in other ways at the tollway as well. Under the leadership of our chairman, we now webcast all of our board meetings. We have proactively put online all information regarding Freedom of Information Act requests that we receive and our responses to them. And since I started the tollway, we've also put in place a construction tracker that clearly shows which companies are getting which contracts on our construction work that we do, and we're going to be working to expand that to other vendors and additional contractors who do work on our system. I think transparency and sunshine are the only ways that we're going to be able to restore public confidence in the agency and the great work that we do.
No political fundraising. I don't believe that that should be part of the TOWAY mission. Under previous administrations, Democrat and Republican, there was far, far too much of that. And we've eliminated that, and we're going to continue to do that.